What is also different is that you can turn off the ESP on this car, and then you can actually do a little bit of a burnout. Hey guys, welcome back to the channel. This is the Born, and this is the first fully electric car by the new Spanish car manufacturer, Cupra. Now, as you may know, Cupra is part of the Volkswagen group, and you can see this Born as the sporty cousin of the Volkswagen ID.3. But according to Cupra, this is more than just a copycat of the ID.3 with some new Cupra logos and some Cupra colors. And today we're going to find out if that's true, because in this video we finally get to drive it. The Born shares a lot of similarities with the Volkswagen ID.3. It's based on the same MEB platform, and it uses the same battery packs and the same electric motors. I'm gonna talk about that a little bit later on in this video, and I'm gonna drive it later on in this video. But first, let's talk about the styling, because that is actually different. Because as you can see, it's clearly styled a lot more sporty. You got these sharp and pointy headlights, and the daylight running lights also look very mean. And on the front end, you also get this copper colored Cupra logo, which is a really funny word to say. And Cupra is also fully written out here on the front as well. There's also a pretty large air intake on the front end, which is pretty special for an electric car, and the ID.3 doesn't have that. And you also get this flashy lip here on the lower part, which really attracts a lot of attention. Basically because of the color copper. You will see a lot of copper colored accents on this car, because that's basically the color of Cupra. The car I have here has 20-inch wheels, which are pretty big for such a car, but they look pretty cool, again because of the color coppered accents here all around the rim. As standard, you get 18-inch wheels. There are also a number of sporty design elements on the side of the car. Take for example the side skirt, which has some sporty curves here at the end. It's only small detail, but all the sporty details all together really give this car a rather aggressive look. The car also sits a little bit lower compared to the ID.3. It's lowered 15 millimeters at the front and 10 millimeters here at the rear, which means that the car has a bit of a sporty stance. So the front end design of this car is completely different compared to the ID.3. However, here at the back end, you can really tell that it is based on the ID.3, especially the C-pillar is just exactly the same as on the Volkswagen. But actually the rear design is different, mainly because of this LED strip that runs all the way across the back. You also get the Cupra logo spelled out on the back as well, and just above that you get the Cupra logo itself. Now if you press it, the hatch will open. Now there's not that much to tell about interior space, or rather cargo space, because that's exactly the same as in a Volkswagen ID.3, and that is 385 liters. Again, like with the ID.3, you get these cutouts around the tail lights. Now the most flashy part on the rear end of this car is the diffuser. It's really big, and of course Cupra is all about sportiness, and that diffuser really tells. Now I don't think it's really that functional, but I do have to admit it looks pretty cool. Just as the cargo space, this backseat area is about the same in size compared to the Volkswagen ID.3. And that's a good thing, because the ID.3 offers plenty of space here in the back. Volkswagen always says that it is the same size as the Golf, the ID.3, but offers the same interior space as the Tiguan, and that's exactly the same in this Cupra Born. So that means that I'm very comfortable here. I'm 1.80 meters, and the seat is in the same seating position as how I would use it, and my knees aren't even close to the seat in front of me, and I also got plenty of headroom left. You get two USB-C ports down here, and the door panels look a little bit sober compared to the door panels you get on the front doors. You get a little bit of a pattern, which looks quite nice, but the door panels are made out of hard plastic. Just like the exterior, the interior looks a little bit more exciting compared to the Volkswagen ID.3. It's mainly the patterns and the materials that they used that give this interior just a little bit more of an edge to it. You get these soft touch materials on top of the dashboards, and you get this like metal look plastic bit here, and some copper colored accents around the air vents. Of course, you get the same layout basically, so the same screen and the same digital gauge cluster, which is connected to the steering column. The screen, however, is a little bit bigger than you get on the ID.3, because on the ID.3 as standard you get 10-inch, and this screen is 12-inch as standard. It is, however, the same system, just with a different digital interface, so with a lot more Cupra logos and copper colored accents. It works all fine, but just like in the ID.3, it's not the fastest system out there. Sometimes it's a little bit laggy, and that can be a little bit annoying. And of course, there are no buttons here. Well, no physical buttons. So you have to do everything on the screen, or either with the sliders down here, which was already pretty hard in the ID.3 when you were just doing like 50 on a normal road. But if you're gonna do some sporty driving, these sliders are gonna be really hard to control very accurately. The center console is also a little bit different. It's a lot higher than the one in the ID3, and that gives you a little bit more the feeling that you are in a sporty car, and it also provides a lot of storage room, and it's also covered in soft materials. In the middle, you get this armrest with some soft materials, almost feels like suede. You also get the material in the door panels as well, here in the front. All materials, or basically all soft materials, are recycled, which is of course the way to go in an electric car. So we talked about the exterior of the car and the interior of the car, but how does it actually drive? And does it drive any different than a Volkswagen ID3? That's probably the most important question of this video. Well, Cupra actually changed quite a few things to the chassis of this car. You got more sportier suspension, and you can choose from different driving profiles. You can go for comfort, then you get a more softer suspension, and you can also go for performance. Then the suspension is quite hard and quite sporty. Now, of course, you already know the DCC system from other Volkswagen Group products, but this system is specifically made for this Cupra on the MEB platform, and you cannot get it on the ID3. What is also different is that you can turn off the ESP on this car, and then you can actually do a little bit of a burnout, which is actually quite fun in an electric car, and which you can definitely not do in a Volkswagen ID3. The steering is also a little bit different compared to an ID3. It's a little bit more heavy, quite a bit more heavy actually, and also pretty direct, not very natural, but you can't really expect that in a car like this with this kind of weight. What is however the same as in the ID3 is the electric motor that is also located in the rear and also producing 150 or 204 horsepower. What is however different in the Cupra is that you can get the e-boost mode, which allows you to get 27 horsepower extra. You get that if you do the kickdown with the pedal to the floor or either pushing the button on the steering wheel. You can also choose from the same battery packs as in the ID3 with 45, 58 or 77 kilowatt hour. If you want the fastest born, you should go for the 58 kilowatt hour battery because that one has the e-boost function, just as the 77 kilowatt hour battery as well. But that battery is a little bit more heavy. And the fastest Cupra born will do 0 to 100 kilometers an hour in 6.6 seconds. In terms of range, the smallest battery pack will provide a range of 340 kilometers. If you go for the 58 kilowatt hour battery pack, you will get a range of 420 kilometers. And if you go for the largest battery pack, which is 77 kilowatt hours, you get a range of 540 kilometers. These seats, by the way, are standard. So standard, you get these sport-like seats. They're not like real bucket seats, but they are quite sporty with the integrated headrest and all. They are quite comfortable because they are quite big, a lot of cushion, which also means that you are sitting up quite high, which is not like really a sporty seating position. But again, they are quite comfortable and they're also really helpful getting in and out of the car. And they're also quite good if you want to do a bit of sporty driving because the sides are quite large, so they will keep you in your place. So I'm going to end this video with a conclusion. No, this car isn't a direct copy of the ID3. It isn't a one-to-one copy. It is actually a little bit different. They actually did a lot of work on it to make sure that it is a bit different, especially on the exterior of the car, also a little bit in the interior of the car. And they actually tweaked the suspension well enough that you actually can notice a difference with the ID3. You can have a little bit more fun with the car, especially if you turn off the ESP. Now, of course, everybody will understand that this isn't some hardcore sports car, but it drives well enough that you can have a bit more fun. And with a 0 to 60 time of a 0 to 100 kilometers an hour time of 6.6 seconds, that's certainly nothing to be ashamed of. So if you're looking for a car in this price category, if you're looking for an electric car and you don't want the ID3 because you think that's a bit too bland and a little bit too boring, and you like to have some fun now and then in the corners, this Cupra Born will give you all you need. So that's it for this video. If you liked it, don't forget to hit that like button. And if you want to see more videos like this in the future, hit that subscribe button, and I'll see you in the next one.